Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for inviting me over here. And before I proceed, I would like to thank you for everything here, but more than everything, seniors from the regiment who have come here. And these are bonds of blood. हम लोग साल में 12 महीने में 2 महीने घर पे रहते हैं और 10 महीने अपने फौजी भाइयों के साथ रहते हैं. When I was in primary school, that was the time when sir was commissioned. That is the difference in seniority. So I was wearing my shorts and going to school, and he was wearing a uniform and going to war. But this love and affection, this regimental spirit, other senior officers from the regiment, there's a youngster there sitting. This is nothing but love and affection. Thank you for that. Thank you, Prabuddha Bharat. Thank you. The topic today is Indo-Pak relations beyond the surgical strikes. Now, we all know why surgical strikes happened. Surgical strikes hui kyun thi? उनका कारण क्या था और वो करनी क्यों जरूरी थी. एसेंशियली मैसेजिंग टू टेल पाकिस्तान दैट इनफ इज इनफ. जितना टॉलरेट करना था हमने कर लिया, इसके बाद हम लोग टॉलरेट नहीं करेंगे, वी विल हिट बैक. नाउ आई हैव माय ओन व्यूज अबाउट दिस होल टॉपिक. और टुडे आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर माय व्यूज विथ यू about Indo-Pak relationship. This was the first time that the Prime Minister of a country, or this is the first time that the government of a nation stood up and said, we take ownership of these strikes. And why is that important? Today the world is celebrating because they were successful. But ladai ke maidan mein to kuch bhi ho sakta hai. God forbid it was not successful. God forbid we had lost a couple of boys. God forbid. Phir kya hota? Then again we had a government and a prime minister who was willing to take responsibility. I think that is extremely important. I have gone across the line of control. Nothing happened because Pakistanis were not there in their bunkers. But local level responses have been there in the past also. Now, having put that context, ek context bata diya maine aapko, ab main aapko aage batata hu ki isme ho. Matlab, jab hum Pakistan ki baat karte hain, hum kehte hain Pakistan ek desh hai, takriban wahan pe kuch 20 crore log rehte hain, aur Pakistan ki capital Islamabad hai. Agar aap sach poochhein, तो पाकिस्तान की जो पॉपुलेशन है वो तकरीबन 8 लाख की है और पाकिस्तान की कैपिटल रावलपिंडी है. ये सच है. द डेस्टिनी ऑफ दैट नेशन इज कंट्रोल्ड बाय द मैन इन खाकी. और ये पाकिस्तान के सियासतदान हैं कौन? हुआ दीज पीपल हु मार्च विद द फ्लैग ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी इन पाकिस्तान. जुल्फिकार अली भुट्टो, who was hanged by General Zia-ul Haq. Zulfikar Ali Bhutto ko politics mein kaun laya? There was a man he called daddy. Pyar se usko daddy bolte the, Zulfikar Ali Bhutto sahab. General Ayub Khan. General Ayub Khan, the original architect of the China-Pakistan economic corridor, along with Bhutto. General Ayub Khan, a military dictator, brought Zulfikar Ali Bhutto to power. He made him a politician. In 1983, a middle-level businessman from Punjab in Pakistan was handpicked by General Zia-ul Haq and made the finance minister of Punjab. This young businessman had not won any election. Na koi political leader tha. Uska ek qualification tha. loyalty. That young industrialist who had a few steel companies, etc., his name was Nawaz Sharif. Nawaz Sharif ko apne corporate office se utha ke Punjab ka finance minister bana diya. Cut to 2018. Cricketer Imran Khan, 2013 ke pehle Imran Khan ne kabhi kuch nahi jeeta tha. He had lost all elections. What happened between 2013 and 2018? I'll tell you what happened. Imran Khan suddenly realized ki agar aap Taliban ke khilaaf baat karenge, agar aap terrorism ke khilaaf baat karenge, aur agar aap fauj ke khilaaf baat karenge, you will amount to nothing in the Islamic Republic of Pakistan. You will amount to a big fat zero. After 2013, Imran Khan changed track. And he changed track so much that people started calling him Taliban Khan. Overnight, he became a champion of the Taliban. And suddenly, Taliban, who were terrorists before 2013, in 2014, they became Bhatke Hue Naujawan. He's talking about a direct affiliate of the Al-Qaeda network. So, ye baat hui. Then he started supporting the Pakistan army. We'll come back to Imran Khan later during the course of this speech. Pakistani army ka role kya raha hai? In India, the tallest leader at the time of independence, mass movement thi independence ki, at that point in time, was Mahatma Gandhi, who was the father of the nation, who became the father of the nation, was declared such. He was a lawyer. And good friend Jinnah was also a lawyer across. Gandhiji said, mujhe siyasat se koi zyada lena dena nahi hai. Maine jo karna tha, maine karkura di. Ab kahani khatam hogi. No, Jinnah, you carry on. Jinnah carried on. Jinnah became the Sarve Sarva, the Lord and Master of Pakistan. India got a constitution within the first 4-5 years of its independence. And Pakistan's constitution has been torn 4 times. Famously picked up the constitution of Pakistan in his right hand, General Ziaulhaq, and said that this is so much, so many pieces of worthless paper, I hereby tear them and throw them inside the dustbin. And the assassination of the leaders. And the assassination of the first Prime Minister of Pakistan, Zulfikar Bhutto, his daughter Benazir, exile of Nawaz Sharif, who lived for 10 years in Jeddah. What does this tell you? And how is it connected to the surgical strike? This tells you one simple thing. When you start developing a mind of your own in Pakistan as a politician, remember that Big Brother is watching. Big Brother will pull you up. It could mean death, it could mean exile, or it could simply mean a disappearance. Before we move on to Kashmir, because surgical strikes took place in the Jammu and Kashmir area, when I was in London, I had gone to give a series of lectures there. I spoke at the British Parliament, I spoke at Oxford, I spoke at King's College London and other places. And I made friends with a Pakistani journalist who was from their so-called Azad Kashmir. And while having dinner together, I said ki, aapke Kashmir mein kya haal hai? So he said, Major sahab, aisa hai ki kam se kam aapke Kashmir mein, yani Indian Kashmir mein, azadi mangne ki azadi to hai. Mere rishtedar ne aisi kuch bol diya tha, 3 saal se usko dhoond rahe hain. His relative spoke something which was against the state line. Kyunki wahan pe bhi kabhi kabhi azadi ka bhoot chad jata hai log. So entire families disappear. in Pakistan. And it is common in Baltistan. It is common in that entire so-called Azad Kashmir, jo bolte hain, Pakistan occupied Kashmir. Aur Balochistan mein to hai, Sindh mein hai. This is extremely common. Now, having set the terms of reference of today's talk, why the surgical strike became necessary, and to my mind, and there can be various reasons, you know, people can say that, nahi sir, hume aisa lagta hai ki shayad iska karan ye hoga, ya fir hume lagta hai ki shayad iska karan ye hoga. Feel free to disagree with me. I will tell you what I feel. This so-called jihad, this artificially manufactured jihad in Kashmir, which was a laboratory experiment, this started in 1989. Why not in 79? And why not in 99? It started in 1989 because the first so-called Afghan jihad had started to wind down in 1989. Gorbachev was the president. We have heard of glasnost. We have heard of perestroika. We have heard about the breakup of the Soviet Union. There were 3 million refugees in the refugee camps of Peshawar. And then there is the story of Operation Topak, how they were funneling funds from here and supporting the so-called Mujahideen in Kabul and how it came to Srinagar. Now, India decided to head back. And one of the weapons that India used to head back was where Major General Sohi has been posted, the Rashtra Rifles, by far India's most successful military experiment. Now, what happened was that the Pakistani generals realized over a period of decades that not fighting with India is very profitable. And not fighting with India is personally profitable. Two quick examples, one analogy and one example. I was giving this speech at Oxford University, and there were a few Pakistani students sitting. And they said, India apne aap ko bahut badi democracy kehta hai, ye kehta hai, wo kehta hai, ye sab jhoot hai. I said, theek hai. Aapke father kya karte hain? My father is a corps commander in the Pakistan army. I said, kaun sa Indian general hai jiska bachcha Oxford mein padhna afford kar sakta hai? An Indian general gets his pension. What does the Pakistani general get? When General Rahil Sharif retired, he got 93 acres of prime land in Islamabad. So when you have 93 acres of prime land in Islamabad, you become a multimillionaire on the date of retirement. And then there is this huge scam in Pakistan called the Fauji Foundation. I don't know how many of you have heard of the Fauji Foundation. The Fauji Foundation is a group of companies controlled by the Pakistani military. And the total net worth of the Fauji Foundation is over $20 billion. Billion bravo, not million Mike. Billion bravo, $20 billion. From fertilizers to real estate to that breakfast cereals to steel, stock exchange manipulation. These group of companies do every single thing in Pakistan. And the generals of Pakistan and the officer class of Pakistan and even the jawans, these people are direct beneficiaries of the Fauji Foundation. Now, there would be many amongst you here who would be businessmen who run their own companies. What does a businessman want? He wants stability. He wants a continuity of regime. And he wants basic laws that can protect his business and his interests. How did the Pakistani army do that? How did the Pakistani army protect its massive, massive business interests? It did so by the same principle that America did. America outsourced business, Pakistani army outsourced jihad. Two decades back, the motto of the Pakistani army was unity, faith, discipline, which was given by Muhammad Ali Jinnah. Unity, faith, discipline. 2 decades back, they changed it. Iman, taqwa, jihad fi sabilillah is the current motto of the Pakistan army. Jihad in the path of God. So, you have Hafiz Saeed of the Lashkar-e-Tayyaba, who was, by the way, running a small quote-unquote NGO to look after the Afghan Mujahideen who were hurt in the jihad. That is number one. Handpicked by General Ziaul-Haq. Sayyid Salahuddin, chairman United Jihad Council and the head of Hizbul Mujahideen. He fought an election in India, he lost, after which he became a terrorist. And then there is Maulana Masood Azhar of the Jaish-e-Mohammed. Now there are small little other terror outfits here and there who keep on jumping up and down, but these are the major players in Kashmir as far as terrorism is concerned. Kabhi kisi ka sikka bhari ho jata hai, kabhi kisi ka sikka halka ho jata hai. Depends on the strike rate of Rashtra Rifles. Sometimes, there was a time I was speaking to an RR officer and he says that the biggest problem that Lashkar is having is that nobody is willing to become the commander in Kashmir of Lashkar. He says, Kani sahab, ye toh bada jokham wala kaam hai, RR wale maar dalte hain. And they keep on killing the commanders. So for a very long time, 6 to 8 months, they didn't have commanders. Achha, inki aadatein bhi kharaab hai, selfie lena shuru kar dete hain ye log. Aapne dekha hoga Facebook pe. He'll take an AK-47, he'll take a selfie. Achha, not realizing that you're signing your own death warrant. Now they know what you look like. And Rashtra Rifles is a force. I'll tell you how it is different, apart from the fact that there are structural differences. There is a significant amount of force in the Rashtra Rifles, which is always there. You know, the location is the same. For example, 13RR is from my regiment. And 13RR is in Manasbal, for example, which is just ahead of Srinagar, not very far. So it has been in Manasbal for a very long time. The manpower will keep on rotating. So at any point in time, you will have sufficient people with sources on ground, with knowledge of the geography. It's not a completely new unit going there. There is always that ground level knowledge that is available. And that is why RR is so successful. So they started having these problems. So what did they do? When these people started getting killed, in the 2000s, there was a time of relative calm in the Kashmir Valley. There were officers driving up and down from high altitude warfare school, which is in Gulmarg, to Srinagar. No convoy. Normal tha. Pakistan realized that this is going out of hand. You know, we commit a mistake and there is somebody waiting to take advantage of that mistake. And we should not blame the Pakistanis for that. We need to look within. So Pakistan changed the entire narrative. Aaj ki tarikh mein, agar aap kisi stone pelter se baat karenge. I know a stone pelter. I'll not take his name. He is known to me. He's a leader of 500 stone pelters and he's pursuing higher education. He uses stone pelting to fund his education. So it's a business. Like, so Pakistan ne kya bola? Narrative change kar diya. Pehle narrative kya tha? Hame kya chahiye azadi? Azadi ka matlab kya la ilaha illallah? Abhi kya narrative hai? Abhi narrative ye hai, sharia ya shahadat. there is massive radicalization which is going on in Jammu and Kashmir. Massive radicalization. Rohingyas entered India from Assam and Bengal. They crossed all the states only to settle in Jammu. Now, there are Rohingya settlements elsewhere also. But they settled in Jammu and they have got solid local support in Jammu. Number two, in almost 30 years of this terrorism happening in Kashmir Valley, which was earlier militancy, now it turned to terrorism. In these 30 years, there was nobody from the rest of India who said that we will go to Kashmir and fight jihad with you. There's nobody. Like, you would have seen kids from Kerala, from Hyderabad going to fight in Syria with the ISIS. You would have heard that news. Baki Hindustan se koi nahi ja raha tha wahan pe ladne ke liye. Pichle 6 mahine mein do waqiye hue hain. Ek Hyderabad se, there was a young man from Hyderabad and another one from Assam who had no idea about conflict. But they knew that their life in this world was wasted. But if they died, agar wo ladte ladte shaheed ho jayenge, they would go to a better world where they were respected. And then, of course, they came face to face with Rashtra Rifles and unki bhi mang puri ho gayi. But, you know, one must always understand this thing of what Pakistan is doing in Kashmir. Number one, a 70-year-old history of military rule directly or indirectly. Maine aapko bataya tha ye sab, ye Pakistani dictators ke hai, ye log pale pose hai ye, sab ke sab. That is number one. Number two, an economy that revolves around terrorism, an economy that revolves around Afghanistan and Central Asia, an economy that revolves around the interests of a particular class of people, whether it's the Vaderas of Punjab or Sindh, or whether it's the military class or the top politicians, those top 400, 500 families who run Pakistan. So Pakistan ne ye shuru kara. Further radicalization. I wish somebody would file an RTI and say and ask these very valid questions. Hum log kya thoda sa dar jate hain when you ask a direct question. Log kehte hain yaar, don't make a communal statement. This is not a communal statement. We're talking facts. And we are just saying that pichle 10 saal mein jitne madarse bane hain Kashmir mein, main Kashmir Valley ki baat kar raha hu. I'm not talking about Jammu, I'm not talking about Ladakh, I'm talking about Kashmir Valley. And by the way, before I come to this madarsa thing, do you know how big is the Kashmir Valley? Which people say, which Pakistan says is a nuclear flashpoint, blah, blah, blah. Kashmir Valley is not more than 135, 140 kilometers long and 30 to 40 kilometers wide. Kashmir Valley is this much, by the way. Now, so when we speak about these things, about these madarsas which are there in the Kashmir Valley, all the maulvis of the madarsas, which at one time were 100% Kashmiris, are now from Deoband, are now from Bihar. Most of them. There is something that is happening and we are ill-prepared as a nation. We are hopelessly ill-prepared. Hum log kehte na Mumbai mein barish hui, Mumbai mein bomb dhamake hue, lekin wo Mumbai kar ki spirit hai. Wo spirit nahi hai kisi ki, na Delhi wale ki, na Mumbai wale ki. Usko bacche ko khana khilana hai, isliye bechara dar ke mare office jata hai. And the question here is very simple. You want to be a superpower? You want to sit on the high table of the United Nations Security Council? That table is meant for the strong. It is meant for the powerful. it is not meant for people who say that when an enemy slaps you, show the other cheek. It is not meant for those people. तो हम बतौर कौम अपना दिमाग बना लें कि हमें चलना किस डायरेक्शन में है. वेर आर वी गोइंग, वेर डू वी वॉन्ट टू रीच. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू बिकम अ सुपर पावर, लेट मी टेल यू दिस, एंड आई एम नॉट सेइंग इंडिया शुड डू द सेम थिंग, नेवर. आवर मॉरल स्टैंडर्ड्स आर फार फार हायर. बट आई कैन टेल यू वन थिंग, अमेरिका, रशिया, चाइना, ग्रेट ब्रिटेन, फ्रांस, these are the five permanent members of the United Nations Security Council, and these are the five worst human rights violators in the world. Aap kisi ki history dekh lijiye. Mao Tse Tung killed 30 million of his own people. Stalin killed 25 million of his own people. America introduced slavery to the entire world. Ye cotton plantations jo the, slaves aaye the. At that time, they were derisively and in a derogatory manner called Negroes, whom we call the African Americans today. France, they wiped out entire North Africa. And England ruled half the known world. ये लोग हैं जो आपको सबक सिखाते हैं कि आप ना कश्मीर में गलत कर रहे हैं, आप ह्यूमन राइट्स वायलेट कर रहे हैं. These are the people who teach you. And we say, yes, sir, you are probably right. Now, how is awareness spread as far as Pakistan is concerned? In 1949-50, I forget the year, Pakistan started a small military capsule, a small team called the ISPR, Inter-Services Public Relations, which is the media management and the propaganda wing of the Pakistan Army, Armed Forces. But when you say Armed Forces in Pakistan, it basically means the Army. Oh, Navy Air Force ko jyada hawa to rehti nahi wahan pe. I'll just tell you, in 1965 war, after the Pakistani Army attacked India in the Akhnoor sector, how many of you heard of Madam Noor Jahan, that favorite singer, famous singer? To purane log jante honge. आवाज दे कहाँ है दुनिया मेरी जवां है, बड़े फेमस मैडम नूर जहाँ के गाने. मैडम नूर जवान जहाँ ने बड़े पेट्रियोटिक सॉन्ग्स भी गाए थे पाकिस्तान में. तो पाकिस्तान का जो एयर चीफ था, वो दैट पुअर जेंटलमैन वॉज लिसनिंग टू द रेडियो, टीवी था नहीं उस वक्त, ही वॉज लिसनिंग टू द रेडियो, एंड सडनली रेडियो में मैडम नूर जहाँ के गाने आना शुरू हो गए. जब पाकिस्तान टीवी पे मैडम नूर जहान गाती हैं या पाकिस्तान रेडियो पे मैडम नूर जहान गाती हैं, तो इसका मतलब या तो वॉर हो गया या कू हो गया. वो तभी गाना चलाते हैं, वतन के सजीले नौजवान आगे बढ़े चलो टाइप्स, दे कीप ऑन. सो ही गॉट अ लिटिल वरिड आफ्टर ही हर्ड मैडम नूर जहान, ही कॉल्ड अप, ही सर कोई मसला तो नहीं है? कह रहा हाँ सर कोई ज़्यादा नहीं सर, वी जस्ट क्रॉस्ड ओवर इनटू अखनूर सर थोड़ा सा. ही एक्चुअली डिड नॉट नो, एंड दिस इज ऑन रिकॉर्ड. सो please understand the power structure that you are talking about in Pakistan. Why am I giving you all these examples? Because the topic of the lecture clearly is Indo-Pak relations beyond surgical strike. Main ye sab kyon bata raha hu aapko? When you talk about Indo-Pak relations, you must know the beast that you're dealing with. Who are you dealing with? John Kerry, Secretary of State, former, he says hello to the Prime Minister of Pakistan, and then he takes his convoy and he goes to Rawalpindi, which is around 22 kilometers away, and he pays his regards to the Chief of the Army Staff. Why? Every visiting dignitary in Pakistan goes and says hello to the Chief of the Army Staff, or the Chief of the Army Staff says hello to him. Because that institution controls the country. Kaam nikalwana hai to Pakistani army se nikalwana hai. Yani ki foreign policy char mulkon ki. India, America, China and Afghanistan. The foreign policy of these four countries vis-a-vis Pakistan is managed by GHQ Rawalpindi. नवाज शरीफ को बड़ा प्यार आ गया था हिंदुस्तान पे. सो ही सेड कि देयर शुड बी अ रीसेट इन रिलेशंस. और मोदी जी मेरे बड़े अच्छे दोस्त हैं, और उन्होंने दो तीन बार मोदी जी बोला. तो फिर उसके बाद क्या हुआ कि इलाज के लिए ही वेंट टू लंडन. ही वेंट टू लंडन फॉर अ बाईपास सर्जरी. And one of the visitors during that bypass surgery was the head of the ISI. He came to say hello to the Prime Minister. So jitni mohabbat Nawaz Sharif ke muh se tapak rahi thi, after the visit, after the bypass surgery, they say Nawaz Sharif had a change of heart. What happened was that he says, main Hindustan ke daant khatte kar dunga. Wo buke buke lekar gaya tha Nawaz Sharif ke paas, and he told him ki sir ye आप जो कह रहे हैं दिस इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल सर, थोड़ा सा मतलब आपको वापस भी आना है. एंड बड़े तमीज़ से, मतलब नथिंग इंसल्टिंग, सर आप देख लीजिए बाकी आपकी मर्जी है. तो इसे नहीं नहीं कोई दिक्कत ही नहीं है. सो ही सेड इंडिया के दांत खट्टे कर देंगे और हम देख लेंगे और कश्मीर आज़ाद होकर रहेगा एंड ऑल दैट. दैट इज द काइंड ऑफ इन्फ्लुएंस दैट पाकिस्तानी आर्मी वील्ड्स इनसाइड पाकिस्तान. नाउ ISPR आई वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट, ISPR स्प्रेड्स misinformation and disinformation in Pakistan at a very, very massive scale. Disinformation at a very massive scale. For example, choti si baat. Aur yehi mujhse Oxford mein bhi pucha gaya. Wo jo Pakistani journalon ke bacche baithe the, wo BMW 7 series aur sab khadi thi college ke bahar unki. So they said there are 700,000 Indian Army troops in the Kashmir Valley. ये आप लोगों ने फिगर बड़ा देखा होगा, 7 लाख फौज है, 700,000. But it largely depends on the mood of the Pakistanis. कोई 8 लाख भी बोल देता है, कोई 1 million भी बोल देता है. मतलब but 7 lakhs is generally accepted in Pakistan that हाँ 7 लाख तो होगी होगी. And now they have also started believing their own lies. They start believing हाँ 7 लाख है. तो I asked this lady, this young student, Pakistani Corps Commander's daughter, क्या बताएं आपको कैसे पता. I asked her, how do you know? You said 7 lakh troops. How do you know there are 7 lakh troops in the Kashmir Valley? He said, everybody knows. I said, everybody में कौन, तुम्हारे चाचा मामा कौन शामिल है? Everybody knows. Who is everybody? So he said, no, there are various reports, Amnesty International reports. I said, you have a smartphone with you? प्लीज टेल मी अ क्रेडिबल रिपोर्ट, आई विल अपोलोजाइज टू यू. सॉरी बोल दूंगा मैं गलत हूं, आप सही हो, ठीक है. तो दिस इज द काइंड ऑफ लाइज दैट दे स्प्रेड. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू हियर आर एक्टिव ऑन सोशल मीडिया एंड हैव हर्ड ऑफ कुनान पुष्पोरा? कुनान पुष्पोरा इज अ विलेज इन कश्मीर वेयर दे सेड दैट इंडियन आर्मी ट्रूप्स वेंट एंड देयर वाज massive rape in the entire village. That case was investigated thrice. First Indian Army investigated, they said nahi ye to interested party hai, hatao, theek hai. Jammu and Kashmir police investigated, they said nahi to police hai, ye to compromised party. Then Mr. Varghese was sent from Delhi, a noted human rights activist, and I think press information bureau ka wo. He was some senior person of the press information bureau. Now, ye jo the ye, I'm sorry, there is something wrong here. Yeah. So he was sent, Mr. Varghese was sent, and Mr. Varghese said there is nothing wrong. Kunan Pushpura did not happen. But today, if you go to Kashmir Valley, you ask any youngster, he will swear on his life Kunan Pushpura happened, because that is the power of social media. Mass graves found in Lolab Valley. A picture is floating around in downtown Srinagar. Mass graves found. 103 dead bodies, 23 children, with the caption. Obviously, everybody gets angry. You look at the picture, and then when you investigate with the help of technology, you find out that this image is actually from Syria. सीरियस इमेज लेके पीछे आपने कोई पहाड़ वहाड़ आपने बना दिया, ऐसे फिरन वाले चार पांच बंदे ऐसे खड़े कर दिए, और बच्चे तो बच्चे ही हैं. दिस इज डन एट अ रेगुलर बेसिस इन कश्मीर. दे विल इन्वेंट थिंग्स आउट ऑफ थिन एयर. नाउ वंस द सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक्स हैपेंड एज अ रिस्पॉन्स टू पाकिस्तान्स deliberate provocations, Pakistani army did one thing that it is an expert in. Aur India ki aur koi bhi army hai aisa kaam kar hi nahi sakti jo Pakistani fauj kar sakti hai. Pakistani fauj ne bola ki janab ye to hua hi nahi tha. That is what they do. 1965 war hum jeet gaye. You would have heard Pakistani saying this very frequently. We won 1965 war. Then they'll give some sort of data. If any Pakistani on social media ever says that we won the 1965 war, you please tell him, why did you launch the war? You launched the war to take Kashmir. That was the primary objective of the war. When you could not fulfill your primary objective, how is it that you won the war? Nahi, fir wo draw ho gaya tha. It's not a badminton match. Draw ho gaya tha. You failed in your primary objective, end of story. We were successful in our primary objective in 1971. The Indian Armed Forces created Bangladesh in 14 days flat. It's a successful military operation. Kargil mein humne Indian Army ke daant khatte kar, kya khatte kar diya? They talk like a typical cigarette Bollywood movie, daant khatte kar diya. Kaise daant khatte kar diya? हाँ, हमारे 527 शहीद हुए थे, नो डाउट, बट वी थ्रू दम आउट. सो व्हेन वी कंडक्टेड द सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक, द फर्स्ट रिस्पॉन्स ऑफ पाकिस्तान वॉज कि जनाब ऐसा हुआ ही नहीं है, हम तो मानते ही नहीं. अनफॉर्चुनेटली अ फ्यू पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज आर आल्सो सेइंग द सेम थिंग, कि सिर्फ हम नहीं कह रहे, इंडियंस भी कह रहे नहीं हुआ था. सो दे फाउंड अ सोलमेट हियर एंड दे सेड कि हाँ सब ये भी कह रहे हैं, ये भी कह रहे हैं, और सब लोग कह रहे हैं, तो अब इसका मतलब नहीं हुआ है. सो वी हैव अग्रीड कि नहीं हुआ है. मुझे ऐसा लगता है, वाइल द सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक्स वर अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट मैसेज, वी मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड वन बेसिक फंडामेंटल. एंड आई हैव ट्राइड वेर एवर आई हैव गॉन, दिस इज नॉट द फर्स्ट टाइम आई एम सेइंग इट, आई ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन दिस फंडामेंटल टू अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स, होपिंग दैट वन डे समबडी अपस्टेयर्स विल हियर इट एंड मे बी इट विल फाइंड रेजोनेंस विद समबडी. कोई सोचेगा कि हाँ यार, ये बात में दम है ना, ही इज सेइंग समथिंग विच इज ऑल राइट. इट्स लाइक यू हैव अ हाउस and you have a lawn outside the house. Har hafte aap us lawn ki ghaas kaatte hain. Ab isme ghaas ki to galti nahi hai. That is the policy you must have with Pakistan. This grass cutting must happen regularly. You can't have a surgical strike once and say it is enough. General Soi made a very, very pertinent comment. He says, Pakistan does not understand this language. Jo aap log baat karte na, diplomatic language, unko samajh mein nahi aati. Why? Because wahan pe fauji hain. A general will never understand diplomatic language. He's not trained that way. We will go there and then we will do this, and United Nations mein we will say this. Unko koi farak nahi padta. You have to speak to them in the language they understand. Unfortunately, Pakistan understands only the language of violence. If you ask me, what is Pakistan? And this is how they have defined themselves. Main nahi bol raha hai. This is how they have defined themselves. What is Pakistan? Pakistanis will say, we who are not India. The definition of Pakistan is we who are not India. You have created a context for 70 years ki hum har tarike se inse alag hain, ye hamara dushman hai. Ab aapne dushmani jo pal li mere sath aur main aapse 5 guna bada hu aur meri fauj aapse tagdi hai, my diplomacy is far better than yours, my economy is a million miles ahead of yours. So you build up a victimhood complex inside your own country. कि हिंदुस्तान बड़ी मैली नजर से हमें देखता है. एंड देन आफ्टर हैविंग ब्रेन वॉश्ड योर पॉपुलेशन यू टेल योर पॉपुलेशन दिस कि अगर बिजली तुम्हारे घर में नहीं आ रही, अगर नलों में पानी नहीं आ रहा, अगर तुम्हारे बच्चों के पास तालीम नहीं है, अगर तुम्हारे माँ बाप के पास सेहत के रास्ते नहीं हैं, अगर तुम्हारे देश में कंट्री में लॉ एंड ऑर्डर नहीं है, डोंट वरी, जिस दिन कश्मीर आएगा नल में पानी भी आएगा, बिजली भी आएगी और हमारी क्रिकेट टीम भी जीतेगी. एवरीथिंग विल हैपन. सो दिस एंटायर नैरेटिव हैज बीन क्रिएटेड कि एक दिन कश्मीर आएगा. And this promise has been made by ruler after ruler after ruler after ruler. Only last few years Pakistan was saying, and even today Pakistan says, Kashmir is the core issue. And we say that terrorism is the core issue. Let us step forward and say, yes, Kashmir is the core issue. Achha, maine keh diya Kashmir is the core issue. Fir, what will happen? Nothing will happen. If Kashmir is the core issue, they should realize there are Punjabis in Pakistan, there are Sindhis, there are Baloch, there are so many ethnicities. Everybody is being massacred only for this mad dream called Kashmir. Pakistan ki national language, main aapko batata hu, Pakistan ki do cheezein batata hu aapko, tabhi aapko surgical strikes ka pata lag jayega. Pakistan ki national language kya hai? Urdu. Do you know less than 5% of the people in Pakistan speak Urdu? The mother tongue of 45-46% of Punjabis is Punjabi. They speak exactly the same Punjabi with slight differences that is spoken in India. Sindhi speak Sindhi. Balochi speak Baloch. Pathan speak Pashto and Dari. Urdu kaun bolta hai? Urdu wo bolte hain jo yahan pe UP aur Bihar se gaye the. They speak Urdu and they have settled in and around Karachi. जिन्होंने MQM पार्टी बनाई थी अपनी, महाजर कौमी मूवमेंट, फिर बाद में उसका मुताहिदा कौमी मूवमेंट नाम चेंज कर दिया था. They are the people who speak Urdu. Nobody speaks Urdu. And during the debate when I said that 1947-48 war के बाद जो ceasefire line थी, फिर 1960 को line of control बता दिया, तो कश्मीर वैली का विभाजन हो गया. It was divided. कश्मीर वैली. Now I would request you to go on internet. Go on the official website. Go on the official website of so-called Azad Kashmir. What is the ethnicity of the people of so-called Azad Kashmir? The ethnicity of the people in Kashmir Valley is Kashmiri in India. It is Kashmiri. They speak Kashmiri. They eat Kashmiri food. They wear Kashmiri dress. The ethnicity of the so-called state of Azad Kashmir is Punjabi. How? Now, sabse pehla sawal, aapke Kashmiri kahan gaye? Aur yahan pe Hindustan ki galti hai. There in Pakistan, they finished off the Kashmiri Muslims. You know Nawaz Sharif. Nawaz Sharif claims that he is Kashmiri. And Nawaz Sharif, when English speaks, he looks like Punjabi is speaking. And Nawaz Sharif says, "I am Kashmiri." I don't know for some of this thing. So, jitne bhi ex-servicemen the, they gave them lands in Kashmir. They settled down. The population, just like China did, the population was diluted. Demography, उन्होंने ऐसे manage करी. आज की तारीख में एक्सेप्ट फॉर सम पॉकेट्स इन मुजफ्फराबाद नोबडी स्पीक्स कश्मीरी देयर. दैट सेंस ऑफ आइडेंटिटी इज गॉन. थोड़ा सा वहां पे पहाड़ी बोल लेंगे, थोड़ा सा गोजरी बोल लेंगे, मेन लैंग्वेज इज पंजाबी. देयर इज नो कश्मीरी फूड, देयर इज नो वाजवान देयर दैट कश्मीर इज सो फेमस फॉर. देयर इज नो कश्मीरी म्यूजिक. इट्स फिनिश्ड. दे हैव फिनिश्ड इट. एक तो ये काम कर दिया पाकिस्तान ने. दूसरी चीज जो पाकिस्तान ने शुरू करा था उससे आज भी हिंदुस्तान भुगत रहा है. आई विल कम बैक टू सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक्स. जस्ट वन पॉइंट. How many of you know that what was the final straw on the camel's back which led to the 1971 war? Here, I have many seniors sitting. The final straw on the camel's back was the millions of Bengali refugees who were coming into India. There were other reasons also. But one of the stated reasons, now, war kabhi ek karan se nahi hota, there are 10 reasons. One of the stated reasons was a massive refugee influx into India. And there are Pakistani supporting parties, especially Jamaatul Islami in Bangladesh, who still encourage this. They encourage this, and every day, hundreds of people stream into India, hundreds literally. And the day is not far when in some corner of Uttar Pradesh or Karnataka or Rajasthan or any other state, you will have the first member of parliament or the first MLA who's a Rohingya. Aapne unko aadhar card jo de diya, aapne pan card de diya. If you go to the Sojian cant where the attack took place in JNK, just outside across the road, there is a huge thriving Rohingya colony. Just outside the army. So we are sitting on a time bomb. Relations with Pakistan have to be looked through a certain prism. As long as Imran Khan keeps on saying that he keeps on parroting the army line, he will be in power. The day he stops parroting the army line, Imran Khan will be either shot dead, he'll be hanged, he'll be exiled. Because there is an example of three, four people. So Imran is nothing special. They'll do it to Imran also. How do you engage with Pakistan? And this is not just post-surgical strikes. This is also always, I have maintained, at least after 1965. The problem is not Hafiz Saeed. The problem is not Maulana Masood Azhar. The problem is not Sayyid Salahuddin. Ye sirf mukhote hain. Kal agar aap Hafiz Saeed ko maar denge, to koi aur Hafiz Saeed aa jayega. Aur unke paas 35,000 registered madrasas hain aur lakhon unregistered madrasas hain. Agar ek madrasa se ek ladka bhi taiyar ho gaya ladne ke liye, they can keep on fighting India for the next 100 years. Aur hum log isi cheez mein khush rahenge ki aaj humne 3 maar diye, kal 5 maar diye. They have an unlimited supply. So what is the solution? So you're living in a room, let's say. There is one room aur aapke bagal mein kamre mein ek aur kamra hai. Right? Aur us kamre mein pani ka nal kisi ne khol rakha hai. To pani beh ke aapke kamre mein aa raha hai. तो आपने वाइपर लिया, आपने पोछा लिया, आपने कमरा साफ कर दिया, आपका कमरा साफ हो गया. लेकिन 5 सेकंड बाद दोबारा पानी आ गया. अगर आप ये चाहते हैं कि पानी आपके कमरे में आना बंद हो, तो आपको उस कमरे में जाके नल बंद करना पड़ेगा. ठीक है? और बाकी हम अगले 100 साल तक आपस में झूठ बोल सकते हैं एक दूसरे को. वी कैन कीप लाइंग टू आवरसेल्व्स. But I am of the very firm belief that unless you break the spine of the Pakistan army, nothing will change. This is the monster that we have ignored for the past 70 years. Hum Imran se baat nahi karenge. Oh, mat karo yaar Imran se baat. Na Imran ko farak padna hai, na aapko farak padna hai. Kuch nahi hona usse. Hum cricket nahi khelenge. Achha, ek to mujhe ek baat samajh mein nahi aati. Unfortunately, sara theka deshbhakti ka Bharatiya Sena ne le rakha is desh mein. वो बॉलीवुड वाला अपने गाने भी रिकॉर्ड करवाता है दुबई में जाके, राइट? क्रिकेट वाले क्रिकेट भी खेल रहे हैं, हम खुशियां भी बनाते हैं जी, उनको हरा दिया मैच में. देयर जॉब इज नॉट, दे आर नॉट हैप्पी विनिंग विथ यू, दे आर जस्ट प्रूविंग टू द वर्ल्ड दैट वी ऑल्सो एग्जिस्ट एंड वी आर इन एंगेजमेंट विद इंडिया. क्रिकेट इज वन ऑफ द फैक्टर्स. यू आर डूइंग बिजनेस विद देम, यू आर डूइंग एवरीथिंग विद देम, एंड इट इज ओनली द डेड बॉडीज ऑफ माई ब्रदर्स हु कम बैक इन अ कॉफिन रैप्ड इन द ट्राइकलर. जो फौजी बॉर्डर पे खड़ा है उसकी पर्सनल लड़ाई थोड़ा ना उसका. ही डज नॉट इवन नो हुम इज किलिंग, ही हैज नो आइडिया. एंड दिस कंट्री बिलोंग्स टू एवरीबॉडी, डज नॉट ओनली बिलोंग टू द इंडियन आर्मी, इट बिलोंग्स टू ऑल ऑफ यू, इट बिलोंग्स टू मी, इट बिलोंग्स टू एवरीबॉडी हियर. this mass boycott of Pakistan at a civilian level and at the military level. You know, diplomatic level, isolation, economic level, sanctions. And at the military level, to break the spine, I'm not talking about war here. I would like to think I'm a responsible person. मैं ये नहीं कह रहा जी आप अटैक कर दो आप बम मार दो ये सब नहीं कह रहा मैं देर आर सो मेनी वेज बाई विच यू कैन ब्रेक द स्पाइन ऑफ द पाकिस्तान आर्मी सो मेनी वेज एंड आई कैन जस्ट टेल यू वन थिंग देर इज अ वेरी फेमस सेइंग एंड इट इज द कोर ऑफ माई बिलीफ शमशीर के साए के तले जन्नत पलती है Paradise is under the shade of swords. If you love your country, you must be willing to defend this country with violence. It cannot be defended with peace. You tell the young kids today that there are chapters upon chapters upon chapters of heroes of the freedom struggle. Who advocated peace? Chapters upon chapters. Nobody will tell you about a poem called Zafarnama written by Guru Gobind Singh Ji Maharaj. Kyunki inko farak hi nahi padta. Inko farak hi nahi padta. Nobody will tell you about Chhatrapati Shivaji. Inko farak nahi padta. They don't care about our icons. क्योंकि हमें दुनिया को एक इमेज प्रोजेक्ट करनी है आपने आज अगर मेरे गाल पे थप्पड़ मारा यू आर मोर देन वेलकम सर आप दोबारा एक मारे प्लीज टिल यू आर हैप्पी कीप स्लैपिंग मी आई कीप ऑन टेकिंग इट एंड वी हैव बीन टेकिंग इट 1947-48 दे टुक अवे 1/3 ऑफ कश्मीर वी डिड नथिंग अबाउट इट 1965, they attacked, we did nothing about it. 1999 in Kargil, we did nothing about it. 1993, terrorist violence in Mumbai, stock market, Air India building, they were bombed. We did nothing about it. 26/11, we did nothing about it. Kashmir, we did nothing. Punjab, we did nothing. We have become the nothing state. पाकिस्तान को पता हम लोग यहां पे अच्छा बात लोग बड़ी इंटरेस्टिंग करते हैं अगर आपने पाकिस्तान पे अटैक करा तो उनका आपको पता है उनके पास न्यूक्लियर वेपन है एक बात बताइए जब 1999 में पाकिस्तान ने कारगिल में हमें अटैक करा था क्या हमारे पास न्यूक्लियर वेपन नहीं थे ना हमारे पास देन दिस फियर ऑफ द अननोन इन आवर माइंड्स कौन से हमें पाला ऐसे गया है बेटा स्वेटर पहन लो वरना ठंड लग जाएगी मां बोल रही है अपने बेटे को तो मैं कहता हूं अगर इतना नालायक बेटा है जिसको अकल नहीं स्वेटर पहनने की उसको ठंड लगनी चाहिए क्यों बच्चे को ऐसे पाल के रखा है बेटा रोड ध्यान से देख के वो क्या रोड क्यों नहीं ध्यान से देख के पार करेगा आपने उसको ऐसे बना रखा है कि ये पूरी डरपोक कौम बन गई है पूरी वी हैव बिकम सो स्केर्ड ऑफ एवरीथिंग Zero error, galti na ho jaye kahin pe. And this is what Pakistan knows, this is what Pakistan takes advantage of. And of course, it is supported by China in a very large measure. Agar aapko ye sab cheezein khatam karni hain, aapko sabse pehle iska srot samajhna padega. Srot iska Hafiz Saeed nahi hai, Daud Ibrahim nahi hai. Srot iska Pakistan army hai. The source of all evil in Pakistan is the Pakistani army. Unless you sort out the Pakistani army, you're going to have this problem again and again. Surgical strike to ek thi na? Aapne ek bar kari surgical strike. Parson report aayi, wo camps dobara ban gaye. Wo camps kya hain wo? Jo camps, maine photos dekhi hain camps ki. Wo camps hote kya hain, jinko hum bolte na ki bada terrorist ke camps the. Wo kya shopping mall bana rakha hai wo DLF ka wahan pe. Ped ke niche kuch canvas ke wo hain, kuch wooden structures hain, but that's all. वो 24 घंटे के अंदर बंद करके डिसमेंटल हो जाते हैं यू हैव टू पुट सी फाइनली आई वुड लाइक टू से वन थिंग प्लीज स्पीक टू द पर्सन इन द लैंग्वेज ही अंडरस्टैंड्स You can do diplomacy with any other country in the world. If you try diplomacy with Pakistan, you will fail because you will keep on engaging with Imran Khan. और उसके बेचारे के हाथ में है नहीं कुछ. वो फौज ने उसका काम पे लगा दिया कि तुझे 12 बिलियन डॉलर लेकर आने हैं, हमारा डिफॉल्ट होने वाला है. अब नाउ ही इज गोइंग एंड बेगिंग पीपल. वो IMF से कभी कहता है इससे नहीं मांगूंगा. चाइना ने मना कर दिया. वो वैसे ही उनका एयरपोर्ट है जिन्ना एयरपोर्ट, वो गिरवी है. उनके मोटरवे सारे गिरवी रखे हुए उन्होंने. दे हैव टेकन ऑल द मनी फ्रॉम चाइना. नाउ दे इज आस्किंग सम मनी फ्रॉम सऊदी अरेबिया. सो दैट इज वॉट ही विल कीप ऑन डूइंग. उसका काम, उसको एक काम पर लगा दिया कि सन यू हैव गॉट टू गेट मनी नाउ. यू गेट मनी, लीव ऑल दिस फॉरन पॉलिसी एंड ऑल. तो उसको उस काम पर लगा दिया. फौज क्या कर रही है वहाँ पर? उनके बच्चे ऑक्सफोर्ड में पढ़ रहे हैं, हार्वर्ड में पढ़ रहे हैं और मुझसे उल्टे सीधे सवाल पूछ रही है. काम करते हैं लोग फुल टाइम कि 7 लाख की फौज क्या है और आपकी फौज ने यह कर दिया वो कर दिया. इंडियन आर्मी हैज़ शोन ग्रेट रिस्ट्रेंट इन कश्मीर बिकॉज वी बिलीव दोज आर आर पीपल. ठीक है, वी हैव शोन फैंटास्टिक रिस्ट्रेंट इन कश्मीर. What did पाकिस्तान डू? आपको पता है ये 16 दिसंबर का वाकया पाकिस्तान में आर्मी पब्लिक स्कूल पेशावर जब बच्चों को मारा गया था टेररिस्ट अटैक में. इट वॉज सो अनफॉर्चुनेट. 132-133 बच्चों को मार दिया टेररिस्ट ने. पाकिस्तान ने क्या करा? विद इन 24 hours F-16 एयरक्राफ्ट टुक ऑफ एंड दे स्टार्टेड बॉम्बिंग विलेजेस इन नॉर्थ वजीरिस्तान. दे स्टार्टेड किलिंग देयर ओन सिविलियंस आउट ऑफ रेज. वो बंदे पड़े थे उनके जेल के अंदर जो टेररिस्ट थे जिनके ऊपर ट्रायल नहीं हुई थी. दे वर नॉट इवन कन्विक्टेड. निकाल के पता नहीं 100 से ऊपर फांसी दे दी. मिलिट्री कोर्ट सेटअप करी. और पाकिस्तानी डॉन न्यूज़पेपर है फ्रंट पेज न्यूज़, आर्मी चीफ सेंटेंसेस 13 टेररिस्ट टू डेथ. आर्मी चीफ विल सेंटेंस? ये देश है कि सर्कस है? ऐसे होता है देश में? देर इज नो सुप्रीम कोर्ट, देर इज नथिंग. आर्मी चीफ हेयर बाय सेंटेंसेस एंड देव डन इट. बट वेन इट कम्स टू पनिशिंग द परपेट्रेटर ऑफ 26/11 तो कह रहा सर प्रूफ नहीं है हमारे पास. उन्होंने तो मना कर दिया. जियो टीवी गया था पाकिस्तान का कसाब के घर में. और जर्नलिस्ट तो जर्नलिस्ट होते हैं. वो कैमरा लेके चला गया. वो कहते हैं खवातीन और हजरात ये है अजमल कसाब जिसने टेररिस्ट स्ट्राइक करी, इसका घर है. वो पंजाब के किसी गांव में गए, उन्होंने दिखा भी दिया घर. वो जियो टीवी वाला बंदा गायब कर दिया SI ने. उसकी पूरी फैमिली को गायब कर दिया वहां से. द पाकिस्तानी डीप स्टेट, दे जस्ट कंट्रोल्ड एवरीथिंग ओवरनाइट. They did it. This is the state that you're fighting against, ladies and gentlemen. Aap ek aise mulk ke saath, which is in a state of severe schizophrenia, it has got a severe bipolar disorder, aur ek inka mukhota hai, the democratic dispensation, and the second is the army. And the army is the main power, whether it is in front or in the back. Ek badi interesting, my last thing which I will mention today. एक फौजीज हियर माई सीनियर्स दे ऑब्वियसली नो. पाकिस्तान में एक ब्रिगेड है इस्लामाबाद में, 111 ब्रिगेड इज द 111 ब्रिगेड. इट्स देयर इन इस्लामाबाद. उसका काम ही टेक ओवर करना है. उसका रोल है वन ऑफ द ऑफिशियल, बिकॉज दे हैव डन इट सो मेनी टाइम्स. उस ब्रिगेड को ये बोला है कि अच्छा तुम एक काम करोगे, तुम 2-3 कंपनीज, 1 इन्फेंट्री कंपनी वुड बी करीब 120 odd पीपल. तुम 2 कंपनीज भेज देना पार्लियामेंट हाउस, 1-2 प्लाटून भेज देना PTV, इधर पाकिस्तान रेडियो भेज देना, यहाँ पर मेन बिल्डिंग जस्ट टेक ओवर. उस ब्रिगेड का काम ही है. दे हैव फॉर्मलाइज्ड ओवर थ्रोइंग द गवर्नमेंट. उनकी SOPs बन रखी हैं उसमें. सो नहीं, ऑन अ सीरियस नोट, दे हैव SOPs, दे हैव रिटन SOPs. 111 ब्रिगेड, द चीफ ऑफ आर्मी स्टाफ पिक्स अप द फोन. इज अ पुत्र चक दे, इज अ थैंक यू सर, कीप ऑन फोन, टक डन. एंड ऑल 4 कूज इन पाकिस्तान हिस्ट्री, ऑल 4 कूज इन पाकिस्तान हिस्ट्री हैव बीन ब्लडलेस. नॉट 1 पर्सन हैज डाइड, विच मीन्स दैट इन द सिविलियन पॉपुलेशन देर इज एन एक्सेप्टेंस ऑफ आर्मी रूल. कोई तो प्रोटेस्ट करता, कोई तो कहता कि गलत कर रहे हैं आप, कुछ नहीं होता. सो वेन वी से इंडो पाक रिलेशंस बियॉन्ड द सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक, there should be 3 things, and with this I'll close my lecture. Number 1, acknowledgement of the fact that we are dealing with a dysfunctional state. Let us stop trying to approach and engage with a state like we would do a normal state. Aap Pakistan se waise baat nahi kar sakte jaisa aap England aur France se baat kar rahe hain.
ये हमारी बेवकूफ़ी है, इट इज़ नॉट पाकिस्तान फॉल्ट, दिस इज आवर फॉल्ट. सेकेंडली, अ स्ट्रॉन्ग मैसेज मस्ट बी पास्ड टू द वर्ल्ड कम्युनिटी दैट इंडिया इज नॉट अ नेशन ऑफ लूजर्स. 5 लाख कश्मीरी पंडित निकाल दिया आपने कश्मीर से, कोई कुछ नहीं कर पाया, आज भी रेफ्यूजी कैंप्स में रह रहे हैं. क्यों? आप अपने लोगों को प्रोटेक्ट नहीं कर सकते, फिर आप कहते हो कि जी मुझे यूनाइटेड नेशन सिक्योरिटी काउंसिल के टेबल पर बैठना है. आपको दरवाजे पर खड़ा नहीं देगा कोई, टेबल बैठने की बात कहां से कर रहे हैं आप? हाउ इज इट पॉसिबल? यू आर नॉट एबल टू डिफेंड योर ओन पीपल. इवन टुडे कश्मीरी पंडित्स आर रॉटिंग इन दोस कैंप्स आउटसाइड जम्मू, नोबडी गोज एंड टेक्स अ लुक एट देम. वो कहते हैं मरते हैं तो मरने दो. एंड नंबर 3, please remember that the main culprit here, the 800-pound gorilla in the room, is the Pakistan army. Indo-Pak relations will be decided by one line as to how India wants to engage with the Pakistani army. The reason for the Pakistani army's existence is enmity with India. तो अगर आप सोचते हैं कि सुषमा स्वराज जी अगली बार अगर पाकिस्तान, बाय द वे भगवान करे ना जाएं कभी, पर अगर कभी जाती हैं इस्लामाबाद, शी शुड गो टू रावलपिंडी, दैट विल बी द बिगेस्ट फॉल्ट ऑफ आवर लाइव्स. एंड फाइनली आई वुड लाइक टू एंड अप एंड दिस थिंग यू नो क्लोज माय लेक्चर विद सेइंग दैट इंडो पाक रिलेशंस इज द ड्यूटी ऑफ एवरी सिंगल इंडियन. इट इज नॉट जस्ट द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ द कंट्री और द एक्सटर्नल अफेयर्स मिनिस्टर ऑफ दिस कंट्री और द सोल्जर हू स्टैंडिंग ऑन द लाइन ऑफ कंट्रोल. ये हम सब की जिम्मेदारी है. पाकिस्तान इज एन एनिमी स्टेट. अब मैं आपको इसको ना लाग लपेट करके थोड़ा सा मैं मीठा बना के आपको ये दे सकता हूँ कि वी आर हैविंग ट्रबल्ड रिलेशंस विद, नो वी आर नॉट हैविंग ट्रबल्ड रिलेशंस विद पाकिस्तान. उन्होंने आपके 1000 देशवासी मार दिए, 1000 से ऊपर, हजारों देशवासी मार दिए. दे हैव अटैक्ड योर पार्लियामेंट, आफ्टर विच वी लॉन्च्ड ऑपरेशन पराक्रम. दे अटैक्ड योर पार्लियामेंट, दे अटैक्ड योर स्टॉक एक्सचेंज, दे अटैक्ड मुंबई. They carry out terror attacks inside India. Hundreds and thousands of army, paramilitary, CAPF and Jammu and Kashmir police have been martyred. जब से insurgency शुरू हुई है तब से 1600 तो सिर्फ JNK पुलिस के मारे गए हैं. 1600 बंदे शहीद हो गए JNK पुलिस के सिर्फ. Please take all these things in context and then in your heart and in your mind decide what is the meaning of this Indo-Pak relations beyond surgical strike. तब आपको पता चलेगा कि है क्या ये. What is it beyond the surgical strike that we want to do with Pakistan? Thank you very much. Jai Hind.